Y'all know how we are. Mount Carmel belongs to us, boys. It belongs to God.
Yeah.
Everything in here belongs to God.
Yeah.
Every person, if you're born again, belongs to God.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, I belong to God.
Yeah.
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
I learned that a long time ago. I learned I belong to God. If I don't do what he said to do, I know the results of not doing what he said to do.
Yeah.
I don't care what nobody else said. They wanted to exalt Moses to ownership of the house.
Yeah.
But God had to remind them the position of Moses. What he said? He said Moses was faithful in all his house, but he was a servant.
Yeah.
See, when you're out of position, when you're out of position, you have a habit of getting the big head. And God had to put you back in position.
Yeah.
Oh, come on now. Talk to me, Donald. You ever seen Drew Brees? When he comes to the line, what does he do? He looks from left to right. Because he knows where everybody's supposed to be. Because he is responsible for everyone to be in the right position, because he is the leader of that team. And if they're not in the right position, it is his responsibility to put them in the right position. So sometime before he hiked that ball, he'll say, he'll do this. Move here. Move that. You're out of position. Wait a minute. Watch this. And everybody don't agree with him when he calls them to be in the right position. But he says, falsely, move to the right position. And if they don't move to the right position and he don't like the play, what he call? Timeout. He walks to the side of the sideline. He takes that player with him to the coach. The coach said, get out of taking to listen to the quarterback. If he tells you to move, you move. And every time when I tell you to get in position and you don't get in position, God will call a timeout, pull you to the side, and tell you, get in position. They wanted to exalt Moses into the position of ownership. Bible said he was a servant, not the owner. But watch what he said about Jesus. But Jesus, I like that. Jesus was the son. Oh, come on now. Over all the whole house. His own house. Jesus is over this house.
Yeah.
I don't care who's in position.
Yeah.
I don't care who the pastor is of this church.
Uh-huh.
Jesus is the owner of this house.
Uh-huh.
And Jesus says what's going on in here and what doesn't go on in here.
Yeah.
If it's in Revelation, from Genesis to Revelation, we're going to do it. Because if not, God, just keep reading.
Yes,
the rest of that chapter.
Yes,
you'll find out what disobedience will do to you. It'll put you in a world of hurt. But it said Christ is the son of his own house. Then it asked the question, who house are we? After all that explanation, after explaining the role of Christ being our apostle and our high priest, after he explained that we belong to God. And after he said what the position of Moses was, he asked the question, who house you belong to?
Yeah.
I like to ask the same question.
Uh-huh.
Who house do you belong to? If we are of the house of God, then Christ is our head. And he rules and super rules. And if we are part of his house, the Bible says if we hold fast, we have the confidence in Christ Jesus, and we can rejoice in the hope firm to the end. What does that mean? To have confidence means that there is no wavering in trust. It says, I'm going to trust him for his word. Old folks would say, I will trust in the Lord. I'm going to trust him when things get rough. I'm going to trust him when I can't see my way. And wait a minute, trust is believing no matter what you see or no matter what you hear. I don't care what nobody else says. They're trying to bring empirical evidence that God does not exist. If a house is built, then a builder must exist. Well, there is the universe where the earth sits, the third planet from the sun. And we're in the right position in which life can live. And within the universe, there's the cosmos. And within the cosmos, there's universes of universes. But if there is a building, where is the builder? I don't believe you're here by circumstance. Nobody down here just got pregnant. Somebody had to come together and build you in order to make you. Nobody got here by immaculate conception. There is a builder. And how do I know? Because people say you look just like your mama or your daddy. So there had to be a builder. And if there is a builder, then a building there. There must be a building. And the Bible said you got to have this confidence. And all things, God will take care of you. I don't get worried when hurricane season comes. But I already experienced being delivered through Katrina. And if he can deliver us through Katrina, I don't care what gets into the Gulf. He can and will deliver us. Well, I experience a healing. And if God has healed you, why you scared about disease now? If he's done it before, he'll do it again. That is confidence. Well, if you got confidence, confidence brings about something else. If you're confident in Jesus, you start to rejoice because you got to tell the story. The old folks used to say, I wasn't going to tell anybody, but I couldn't keep it to myself. If God healed you, you got to tell somebody that God healed you. If God delivered you, you got to tell somebody that God delivered you. If God took you off of drugs, you got to tell somebody that God took you off of drugs. There's a rejoicing.
Don't stop.
There's a rejoicing. What he said, if we hold fast to the confidence and the rejoicing of our hope, you got to rejoice in Christ Jesus. I don't care what they say. The old folks, when they was in the slave shack, they used to say, steal away Jesus. I ain't got long to be here. They used to say, way in the water, we got to get out of here. They used to say, some old day, it won't be long. So change is going to come. And that's the confidence that one day that God would deliver them out of slavery and put somebody in the White House. You ought to be rejoicing. Look how far God has brought us from the fields of Mississippi to Pennsylvania Avenue in the White House. He took us from the outhouse to two bathrooms. He took us from the radio to big green TVs. He took us from fanning and a banana to an organ and air conditioner. And you don't have nothing to praise God about. I don't know about you, but I'm going to praise him. Praise him in the morning. Praise him in the evening. I'm going to praise him. Look what he said. Now I'm almost finished. Rejoicing in the hope. And then it said firm until the end. It didn't say weak. Didn't say wavering. Did not say loosely, but it says firm. I'm going to stand. It says stand. It says know that your labor is not in vain.